All right, so let's finish up this example. And where we left off is we're currently dealing with this issue of we've gotten the first character and we're doing something with that. And we've gotten the last character and we're doing something with that. Well, what about all the characters in between? That's our dilemma. And this is a really common thing in programming is there's not just one way to do this. I'm thinking about three or four different ways to accomplish this, and there's probably more than that. But I'm thinking what might be the easiest is the dilemma we're facing is we can just print out the sentence, right? We can just print out the sentence if everything is okay with the grammar, right? We're looking at the first character and we're looking at the last character in this case, but we don't really care about anything between. That's a harsh way of saying it. But we want. We're not going to change anything of anything other than the first character or the last character. So what I'm thinking is because we know that anything between the first character and the last character, if the last character isn't punctuation, because again, we're only going to add punctuation here, right? If there's already punctuation there, we're not going to do anything to the corrected sentence. So what I'm thinking is this. Why don't we just if the first character is lowercase, then make it uppercase and then add it to the corrected sentence. Else, let's still add the first character, but we'll just add whatever it was, right? We won't correct it. We won't make it too uppercase. I'm pausing because I'm realizing we can make this a lot easier. Because we could just make the first character uppercase no matter what. Because that's not going to hurt anything. Right? Is my logic off here? So I've kind of ruined my little example here with that. But that's okay. We went through the learning process, right? This is probably a better way to do it, is to just get that character and then this is the type of thing we do in programming a lot where you realize there's a better way. We can just make it uppercase. So the character that we got, let's make it uppercase. So, well, better yet, just to consolidate comments here, I'll just say get the first character and make it uppercase. So after I've gotten it, then I can say now set ch equal to the character class to upper case and then pass it whatever was in ch, right? So I'm changing it, whatever was in ch, to uppercase and then putting it back in ch. Now I can add it to the sentence. Okay, so I can say take that ch. How did we do it before? So we're going to take the corrected sentence and set it equal to the character class to string, right? Ch. So we're going to add in that first character. No matter what it is, we're going to make it uppercase. So we might be making an uppercase, and maybe potentially there's some argument against doing that in case it already wasn't uppercase because it will save processing power or whatnot, but that gets into very higher level kind of programming stuff. Now we want to copy in the rest of the sentence, whatever it is. So we've already got the first character. Now we want to attach onto that first character that we've now corrected the rest of the sentence. And then we'll check for punctuation in the sentence. That's probably a better way of going about this. So are you getting what I'm saying? We already have the first character, so now if I put the rest of the user sentence in, that's not going to work because I've already put the first character into the string. And there was no way getting around that because either I had to do it the way I was doing it before, whether I needed to check to see if there was a capital letter or not. And so what I'm thinking now is, let's grab the second character to the rest of the sentence and now add that onto the corrected sentence. Okay? So now I'm going to take the corrected sentence and set it equal to whatever it was, which is going to be the first character, and attach on the rest of the sentence. Well, how do I get at the rest of the sentence? Well, again, one of those methods that I have available to me, if I just type in a Java string class, then we'll get back to that link that explains the string, and in the strings I can grab a substring, right? I can grab a part of a string. So substring says, give me the beginning index, and I can either just do a beginning index, or I can do a beginning index and an end index. Well, I just want to grab to the end of the string, so I'm just going to give it the beginning index. So I'm going to say, give me the user sentence dot substring beginning at which character? Well, again, the first character is 0, so I want to start at 1 and get the rest of the sentence. Is that making sense? So now we'll grab from character 1 on, attach that to the first character, and we'll have our sentence. And then what we can do is, instead of doing the check on the user sentence, we can do the check now on the corrected sentence and say, now that we have our corrected sentence, is there punctuation at the end? If there's not a period, and there's not a question mark, and there's not an exclamation point, then let's add on a period to that corrected sentence. Okay? And then we can print corrected sentence system.out.println corrected sentence. Okay. Let's try it. So this is a test. And we get a nice, pretty sentence. And maybe we ought to say something like corrected sentence. Oops, forgot my opening quote. And then concatenate on the corrected sentence. Let's try that. So this is a test. And it capitalizes the T and puts a punctuation at the end. Let's try this is a test, question mark. Then it will just leave that question mark because it had that question mark as some sort of punctuation, but it did capitalize the T. Let me give a sentence that maybe I'd see in my paper. What's up, brah? Okay, well, we don't get the question mark on there, but we do get the capitalization and the punctuation on the end. We've corrected the sentence. All right. So just recapping what we did then, what we ended up doing. We built the scanner to read in the input. We created a user sentence, which is going to be for the sentence that was entered by the user. The corrected sentence, which is our corrected version of that sentence, and then a little temporary char character to hold the char for 1 second while we did something with it. We asked the user to enter a sentence. They enter it. And then we come in and say, let's set this temporary char equal to the user sentence, which is the string dot char at position 0. So it grabs the first character and puts it in this ch variable. And then we say, now go make that character uppercase. So I pass in the character that was there, and then I put that back into the ch variable, which now contains the uppercased letter. Then I set the corrected sentence equal to the string version of that character, So now it's got, you know, if it was blah, it's got that B sitting in that corrected sentence that's an uppercase now. And then I'm going to go into that corrected sentence, whatever was there, and add the rest of the sentence after, beginning at character one, which is the second character in the string. That whole thing now is put back into corrected sentence. So I've got the first character that was already in there, add the rest of the string, and store that in the corrected sentence. Then I say, let's check that last character and make sure it's punctuation. So I set ch, the temp char character, equal to the corrected sentence string dot char at whatever the length of the sentence was minus one. So the last character. I've got that last character in the ch variable now, and I can say if it's not equal to a period, and it's not equal to a question mark, and it's not equal to exclamation point, then go ahead and to that corrected sentence that was already there, add a period, and then store that back in the corrected sentence. Print out the corrected sentence, and then tell the user enter another sentence or press Q to quit, and then read in that sentence. If it's a Q, then quit. Otherwise, keep doing this while it's not a Q. And that is our little grammar correction program. So there's a lot of little things you can mess with this. Like I said, it'd be kind of fun to add in a question mark instead of a period based on what the beginning letter was, or beginning word was, I mean, and some other things. But that's the basic idea. We've used a bunch of the different little character classes or methods, character methods and string methods that are available to us. And we talked about the math class and some of these other classes that allow us to, you know, greatly simplify our programs because they're already built and ready to go for our use to make our lives easier, like I said. All right, hopefully that's kind of helpful to run through that little example together. And hopefully this is fun. I mean, this is kind of interesting to be able to go through and create these programs. We start out with nothing. We start out with just some ideas written down in some pseudocode, and we end up having a program that allows you to go ahead and type in something like Spencer out, and it will capitalize that letter and put the period on the end of that sentence. And you could expand this. You could have it do a whole document, go through and find, well, I guess if there's no punctuation, it's really difficult to find the beginning and the end of the sentence, right? So maybe that wouldn't work. But anyway, hopefully you're enjoying Java and more importantly, programming, because we can program in a lot of different languages. Hopefully you're having fun doing it. Okay. Spencer out.